To play shape dance, use tape or chalk to draw lots of shapes on the floor or on the ground outside. Then play a song that kids would like to dance or move around to. You're going to give them a clue about what shape or type of shape they should stand on. And when the music stops, everyone will need to find a shape that fits the clue you gave them. So you can tell kids, when the music stops, stand on a shape with four sides. Play the music and let everyone walk or dance around to the music for a little while. Then stop the song. And everyone has to find a shape with four sides. Once everyone's standing on a shape, you can ask, what shape are you standing on? How do you know it has four sides? There are lots of possible clues for this game. You could say, stand on a shape that's not a square, or stand on a shape that has more than three sides, or stand on a shape that has no straight sides. You can find more ideas for clues in the instruction sheet for this game on our website. If you're in a small space and don't have room to draw shapes on the ground, you can play this game by spreading out shapes on a table and having children pick up a shape that matches your clue. What's really important in this game is that you're helping children pay attention to the attributes or characteristics of shapes. Things like how many sides and vertices a shape has. And a vertex is the mathematical term for where two sides meet, what you might normally call a corner of the shape. Don't be afraid to use math vocabulary like vertex and its plural vertices with kids. Kids love learning new words, and just like they can learn the names of dinosaurs and superheroes, they can learn math terms too. Shape Dance is a game that you can even keep playing with older kids by giving more challenging hints, like find a shape that has two sides that are parallel like train tracks. And they would need to find a square, rectangle, trapezoid, or other shape with two parallel sides. Or your clue could be, find a shape with a right angle, an angle like the corner of a piece of paper. And they could find a square or rectangle, or maybe a triangle with a right angle. The great thing about this game is you can adjust the difficulty of your clues based on the group you're working with.